in VeChain's white paper, we have introduced our governance model. According to that model, we will have a steering committee serving as the governing body, and we also introduce the voting schemes for the community to vote on important issues such as changing the network parameters, selecting new steering committee members, or other issues where the community think it's necessary to vote. Here, I'm going to talk about how the governance model is going to be implemented on VeChain Thor. So at the center of the system, you will see a building smart contract called executors. As I mentioned before, a building smart contract is the smart contract we deployed in the Genesis block. It also comes with a fixed address. This address is converted simply just from the word executor with the first letter E in capital. So what does this smart contract do? So around the smart contract executor, there are three parties. One is the voting contract, one is the action contract, and also we have the steering committee members. So the voting contract is the smart contract actually carries out all the votings. So the community can initiate a voting inside that the voting contract. All the members, community members, can vote on some issues. The action contract contains all the actions going to be done according to the voting results. For example, we are going to vote on changing our network parameters. So the votes will be registered here. Everybody going to voting in this voting contract. But we will generate a new action contract which says change the network parameters from 1 to 2, for example. That's it. So also a feature of the action contract is it can only be triggered by the executor contract. So nobody else except executor contract can trigger those actions. So then we have the steering committee members interacting with the executor contract. Suppose we have a voting setup inside a voting contract, and everybody goes to the contract and votes, and we have the results. Suppose the vote, the answer is yes. Then what the voting contract is going to do, it is going to propose a proposal to the executor. So it simply just register a proposal inside the executor contract. So what this proposal contains is it tells executor the address of the action contract. Also, it gives the data to the executor, which will later on parse to the action contract. The data will be used to identify which method is going to call and what data is going to parse to the action contract. So after a proposal is registered inside the executor, the steering committee members will have to approve the proposal. So they will have to make sure the voting process is correct. There's no corruptions, for example. There's no weird thing happen. So after that, they approve the proposal. So anybody can trigger the execution of the function of action contract. So there's a method defined in the executor executor smart contract. So everybody can call once the proposal is approved by the majority of the steering committee members. Right, so I have finished all my topics about the VeChain core. Now I would like to give some information about our available tools for developers. We have produced wonderful articles published on Medium. I encourage all the developers who are interested in using VeChain Thor to look at the article. And also I have listed all the tools we have developed so far. You can see we have Thorify, we have Web3 Gear, we have Java Client SDK, we have Sync Desktop, and Thor-devkit. They are all very useful tools, and I strongly encourage you to try them. Okay, guys, here's the exciting thing. I'm going to talk about the current progress of our core development team. I can tell you the team is working very hard to develop some tools to make things easier. So they're trying to make things easier for developer to develop the apps. They are also trying to make things easier for users to use all the apps holding on our blockchain. So basically what they are doing is they're trying to create a VeChain Thor dApp running environment. So the environment includes two major components. So one component here is, you can see, is the account management engine plus the graphical user interface. So what does it do? It allows the users to interact with the apps seamlessly on VeChain Thor. So in its first version, it's going to be like a standalone desktop software running at the background. The second part is a JavaScript API library developed for VeChain Thor. So what it does is it provides a very user-friendly APIs to developers, allow them to use the new features on the VeChain Thor easily. It also provides tools for developers to easily interact with the account manager engine when they're developing the apps. At the end of this presentation, I'm going to talk about IP and research. Inside VeChain team, we have been working very hard to protect all the innovations we created in this team. So far, we have submitted more than 30 patent applications, and these applications are going to protect our ideas and cool technologies. It covers two major areas. One is the infrastructure level blockchain technologies, all the cool stuff in our VeChain Thor platform. So the second area is the blockchain-based enterprise solutions, which includes all the hardware and software we have been developing so far. About research, we are collaborating with some top-tier universities around the world. As I'm not going to mention all the names, you guys already know that. So there are three areas we are focusing on. So the first area is privacy and data sharing. I think the privacy and data sharing issue is very important for all the blockchain platform. We're working on that to provide some solutions to the users of our blockchain to keep their privacy, also allow them to share their data securely and benefit from sharing their data. The second area we're gonna work on is the AI-empowered blockchain. For example, right now, a lot of the parameters on VeChain Thor is managed manually. But in future, I believe AI could change that. It could improve the governance. So we are going to investigate whether there's any AI algorithms which is capable of doing that. And we're going to work with the top university to give it a try for our future blockchain platform. So the third area is the ecosystem design and the modeling. For example, we're going to work with the university to see what is the best economic model for some industry applications. Okay, guys, this is the end of my presentation. Thank you very much for watching, and please leave your comment. Let me know what you think about. Thank you, guys. Bye.